Hey everyone, Daniel here from TwinBytes with another quick tutorial for you, this time on how to clean up or tune up your computer. I've been asked by this a couple different times, and if there's any program, one single program that can do it all, and really the answer is no. There's a few different programs that you can use, and some of them are built into Windows. So I'm going to cover how to clean up and tune up your computer here in this video. The first thing is looking at temporary files. So if you have manually going through your list of Windows temp directory, and there's also your user profile directory, you'll find a whole bunch of different files and folders inside of here that you can just select all and delete. The alternative is using a program such as Ccleaner, where you can have a lot of this automated. It'll look at anything that you have open currently, and it'll tell you if it needs to close anything before running its initial scan. And it only does so much on the free version. You'll see it'll prompt you with a few different things that it can do, but only certain things will be done if you pay for it and get the Pro Edition. So you can click on Make It Better and it'll patch up the computer, making those changes that it suggested. And that's just on the free version. You can see on their website, when you go here to download it, it shows the difference between the free version and the paid version. And it'll give you a lot of the basic stuff for privacy protection and standard cleaning, which does a pretty good job. But there's a lot of other little things that you may want. And it does a little bit deeper cleaning, other type of security scans that it checks for your privacy. And you have support through there as well, which you wouldn't get through the free one, of course. But in most cases, you're not going to be calling them for support. In the program itself, you can actually go into custom clean. You can select what you want to clean out and what you don't want touched. So you can go through here and uncheck whatever you don't want to be touched, but for the most part it should be fine. You may have something like your recycle bin that maybe you don't want it to be cleaned out right away automatically, so you might want to uncheck that if you don't want it to be emptied. But it's a good idea to clean it out, because most people forget about it. And if it's gone to your recycle bin and you haven't gone back to it almost right away after deleting something, then chances are you probably don't need it. So you can probably safely empty your recycle bin. You can browse through some of the other options in here and see if there's anything that you want to get out. For example, on any particular web browser, if you want to keep your history and you don't want to lose that, then you can uncheck those things. So it depends on which browser that you're using. There's also a list of applications, but this is showing the separate programs that are not part of Windows. So here is the Firefox that we weren't seeing in the other window, and there's also Thunderbird, and there's Google Chrome. So I can find my history there. Maybe I want to keep that, maybe not. I know I have mine set to automatically delete every time, which is another option you have. And all the other programs that you can clear out, cache, history, and so on. So I would suggest going through this carefully and having a look at the options before doing anything. But between these two, you can go to Analyze, and it will quickly run and analyze. It'll tell you if anything is open currently that you need to close, then it'll do that for you, and then it'll finish doing the analysis and tell you how much it can actually clean up. Once that's analyzed, you can hit Run Cleaner, and it tells you it's going to remove those things from your computer, and that's fine. So you can go ahead and hit Continue. And it runs through that. Depending on how fast your computer is, it'll be done by the time I finish explaining this. And that's it there. There is one more part in the free version, which is pretty cool, is the registry cleaner. And believe it or not, even when you uninstall programs, it doesn't remove all files for it or all registry entries. So we can scan for issues in the registry, and you can see here that there's a whole bunch of missing shared DLLs, and it's just barely getting started here with scanning for it. But if you want just to look at it for interest's sake, file extensions that aren't used anymore, invalid icons, and just a whole bunch of different type of things. Path issues, we just pass very quickly. Reference issues, that it's referencing things it can't find. So yeah, a whole bunch of things. So once it's done scanning, as it says here, it's 100%, then you can fix selected issues. Do you want to do a backup of the registry before making changes? That is definitely a good idea. You can save it anywhere on your computer that makes sense for you, and then fix all selected issues. And it tells you when it's done. You can hit close, and that's the end of that program. By default, it is running in the background, and it tells you here with a little pop-up, so you can say okay, thanks. And you can see it down here, so it's available by a right click on it, and you can open the whole thing or run it straight from here. The other thing is checking your Windows updates. So point number two, check your Windows updates, because even though it's automatic, you may have an error like I have over here, and it shows that it checked something but it couldn't complete the install because an update service was in the middle of being shut down. So we can hit retry, and it checks again for updates and sees if there is anything left available to install. So it's a good idea to install anything you find here, reboot the computer, and then check again. Now in this case, it's having an issue, so we would just reboot and check again. But this video isn't going into troubleshooting Windows updates. That would be on a different video. But you want to make sure that your Windows updates are working. So in this case, there's an issue. We're going to have to troubleshoot that at some point. Checking for software updates, you can look in your apps and features menu and go through the list of programs, and it's a good way at a glance to see everything that you have installed and find out if they're old, if there's anything newer. This won't exactly tell you if there's updates or how to update them from here, but this gives you a good overview of what you have installed. Each individual program, like Firefox for example, you can go into About Firefox and it checks to see if there's any updates, and it tells you if it's up to date, or if there is an update available, it'll either give you a link to click to update it, or it'll just very quickly say it's updating now, and if you're not fast enough to see it, it's already done. So most of the web browsers do this automatically behind the scenes, and you don't even have to look at it, but it's a good idea to go in there and have a look at that occasionally and make sure it's working. Google Chrome would be the same thing under Help and About Google Chrome, and it says updating Google Chrome. Here's the version, and it is actually in the process of updating. So this one did have an update sitting there, not sure for how long it was sitting there, but it did have something waiting for the next time to go in and have a look at it. If I didn't go in manually, it may have updated automatically behind the scenes while using it, but this kind of pushes it to get going installed a lot sooner, which is a great idea because you always want to stay on top of your updates. So number three is checking for software updates, and this is definitely something that will help you with the security and stability of your computer, because hackers will look at outdated software to expose any vulnerabilities, take advantage of them to get access to your computer. So aside from number three, running software updates for software you have installed, is deleting old unneeded software. So as you go through your list of programs that you have installed, you may find that there's something that you have installed that you don't use, and you can remove it. So you can go in through here and uninstall anything that you don't need anymore. Number five would be to replace unsupported software you still need with a newer version. For example, if you have Windows Live Mail, it's been unsupported for a couple of years at least now, and I recommend replacing that with Mozilla Thunderbird, because it's got a very nice smooth transition that I know works from Live Mail to Thunderbird. It's also free, which is another bonus, because anyone using Live Mail is because it was free and they'd probably want to stick with something free. So any program that's unsupported anymore is a security threat, and if it can't be updated anymore, you have to replace it. So find another alternative that you can easily convert to and start using that and get rid of the old stuff. Whatever antivirus program you have, when you open it, it should tell you that it's protected or it's working or it's current or some kind of wording to that effect, and it usually has the color green in one way or another to indicate that it's working. So something else is to make sure not only is it there, but is it doing its scans? And your antivirus program may work a little different than this, but you should be able to somewhere find a scan history option, and you can look at when's the last time it scanned and how often is it scanning, is it actually working. Now there's quick scans and there's full scans. This is only showing full scans. It doesn't show any quick scans that were done, and I know I did a quick scan before I even started this video today. Also, because this is a managed online program, it's managed and monitored in the cloud. So you may not see all the information and you may not have control over all the settings because it's being managed and monitored in the cloud by your provider. Number seven, even though it's not to do with software, it's the physical machine itself. For a good cleanup, tune-up of your machine is physically cleaning it. So if you're able to open it up, if it's a desktop, it's a lot easier. If it's a laptop, it may be a little trickier. You want to try and open up the side of the case, if it's a box, and blow any dust out with some compressed air. And if you don't have any compressed air, you can get them from anywhere, really. In a laptop, you would try and blow where the fans are. It'll show a little heat sink area of the laptop, and you can blow in through there, and you should see if you place the nozzle of the compressed air on an angle, it'll blow in one way and blow back out the other way. And depends on the laptop, some of them are different. They may have a vent on the two corners, so when you blow it into one corner, it comes out the other corner, or it may be just on the one side and you blow it in on one part of that vent and it comes out the other part of the same vent. As a bonus reminder, you want to do backups. It's not really anything to do with cleaning up or tuning up your machine, but if something goes wrong because you weren't cleaning up properly or with all the great efforts you put in to try and keep it secure and up to date and performing well, it can still crash on you and you could lose all your files. So you need to back up, whether it's to a USB drive that you plug in and just locally copy and paste files manually, or use a program that you can schedule or one click of a button and it copies and pastes them to your USB drive, or some kind of online storage like Carbonite or through our Avast cloud managed backups. It depends on if you want to have your backups managed and monitored, or are you going to have something online that you just have it run and trust that it's actually working and hope that it's still working? You have several options, and we do provide and help you with that. So you can always ask for a list of options, and we're happy to send that information to you for free. Anyway, that's it for this quick tutorial. If I did miss anything, please let me know in the comments below. Also, any other ideas you have for videos, whatever you want to hear about, I'm happy to hear that. So that's it for this video. If you did find it helpful, please do give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and we will see you in the next video. Thanks so much. Bye for now.